Hey everyone, assistant in this site from Innovate Yourself. Welcome back to another exciting video in the series of ESP-IDF.
Itna andhera kyun hai mere bhai?
Iske baad ujala hi ujala hai.
Don't you think the light looks quite very dim, right? So wait, let me just turn on another light so that we have a very good lighting in here. See, the light is turned on. And let me turn this light basically. See, it's turned off. So this is what we will be doing today. I'll show you that how you can control your home appliances using the Firebase account, and accordingly you will also be able to see the present state of that on the Firebase account. So this is all that I'll be covering up today. Today's video will be covered up in four parts. Firstly, we'll see that how to build your own PCB, and in fact you will learn all the other things like creating a schematic, creating a PCB, creating the pattern transfer, how to fabricate. That's all the stuff you will learn. Next, you will learn how you will build your own PCB box, which we will be using to finally deploy our PCB circuit into our place, which I have done right here, right? And thirdly, we will see the coding part where we'll understand a complete architecture. We'll learn all the coding part, how we are controlling it, how we are connecting to the Firebase and all the stuff. And finally, we will see the live demonstration of the application of the device that we will be creating in our today's video. Now, I hope you are really excited to learn the entire stuff which I have covered up in four parts. So let's move ahead and let's understand how are we going to do the home automation with the Firebase and the ESP-IDF. So let's move ahead. All right, everyone. So this is the schematic of our today's project, which we will be using. And you can see like all the components and ESP32 Wroom, which we are using today. So we have all of them with us. So it's assembled and it is connected properly along with all the relays and everything, right? And similarly, we also have over here the PCB, which we will be using to finally get the final PCB ready with us. And it's totally up to you whether you want to order it online so that they will get it done for you, or you can build it for you as well. It's totally up to you, right? And we have the various platform available, right? So you can order from anywhere, right? So this is the one, and in my case I'm also going to make by myself, so that's not a problem. And in case you want to build the PCB and you want to do the complete process of PCB fabrication, pattern transfer and everything by yourself, I'll leave a link in the description about that video where I have already shown you the entire process, like how we will be getting the final PCB ready with us. So it's totally up to you whether you want to order online or you want to watch that video. So I'll add the link so you can watch that. So this is all about this. And also, don't worry about the schematic and the PCB. I'll add a link in the description about the schematic and the PCB as well, so you can download that and you can start making a PCB for yourself, right? So it's totally up to you. So let's proceed ahead with the further steps. I love you when you wait.
hours later.
So everyone, you can see this is our home automation device which is deployed at my place. So you can see this is the main cable which is going to give the power supply to our main board, and in fact the main device is set up inside this. You can see the circuit is like here, and from here we can simply connect which appliances we want to connect. And if you can see right here below this wire, you can see the numbering which I have mentioned just to define like where exactly I have to connect the wire of your appliances basically, right? So this is how we have done it. And this last one which you can see over here, so this one is basically the connection of your main wire in which you have the current, right? Or you can say this is the main line wire, right? And this is the main device, right?
Now let's move to the coding part and let's understand that how are we going to control the home appliances with respect to our circuitry. So here you can see on your screen, this is a code which I have already written, and I'll explain you like what exactly I'm doing in here, right? For that, I'm going in here inside this main.cpp, and currently the format that you're checking for the Firebase code, you have already seen that in our previous videos as well, where we see the demonstration that how we connected our Firebase to the ESP32 so that we can transmit the data and we can receive the data from that real-time database. So here you can see like this is like firebase.configuration file in which we already have the credentials, we already have the SSID and password, we already have the credentials for Firebase, we already have like the API keys and everything. So those all things are in here. And if you're not familiar with this, then please check my previous video, because there I've already explained you from where I'm getting those values and how do you have to save them, right? So this is about firebase_config.h. Now let's come to the main one, main.cpp, in which we have the main code written. Now over here, most of the things is going to be same. We have a difference, and that difference is that this time we will be communicating with ESP32 and the Firebase, and after we are connected to the Firebase, we will be receiving the data from the Firebase side, so that when we will get a request from Firebase, we will process it accordingly. And in our case, we want to process it by controlling the home appliances, and for controlling that, we have four relays, and these are the corresponding pins that I've already mentioned in here. You can see pin number 32, 33, 25 and 26. So these are the four pins which are connected to the relay, which we will be controlling right now with respect to our code. So some of the code is as usual. You can see connecting to the Wi-Fi, connected to the Firebase account, and in fact, the real-time database we're talking about. And now let's come to the main one. So over here you can see we have the initial values over here which I am keeping in here, and just because this process is going to repeat, and it can repeat any number of times, and we don't know when we are going to get the data, so that's the reason we are inside loop. And you can see this is from where we are getting the data, and in the next line we are converting it to the string format so that we can use it accordingly. And just because the data I will be getting, that will be in the string form, but the actual data inside that will be a JSON string, so we have to process that JSON string as well. And for that reason, I am using a header file which I have included on the top, like over here, cjson.h, so that I can work accordingly with the JSON data itself. So that is what I'm doing, and that is the reason you can see here I'm simply creating an object where I am actually getting this string value and I'm actually converting it to the JSON data so that I can access each and every element with respect to the keys that I have in there, right? So that is what I'm doing right in here. And inside that, I am simply having four different keys with the different names, appliances 1, appliances 2, appliances 3, and appliances 4 respectively. So these are all of them, and for each of them we will be getting a value every time. So whatever value I'll be getting from there, I'll be fetching it, I'll be extracting it, and with respect to that, let's say if the value is high, I wanna turn it on. And just because relay works on low logic, if the value is sent as low on relay, then it is going to be switched, or you can say it is going to be turned on. So that is the reason you can see I am sending 0, and in that case my relay will be turned on. And accordingly, if the value is 0, in that case I'll be turning it off, right? So this is about the first appliances. Same thing is going to repeat for the other three appliances as well. So this is the first one, this is the second one, this is the third one, and this is the fourth one. So in this way I'm getting the value for all of them, and accordingly I am controlling my appliances with respect to the relay. So this is about the complete functionality, complete coding part. I hope you have got it. Now let's do one thing, let's upload the code so that we can test the functionality of it in live. So for that, just open the terminal. And one more thing, don't worry about the code, you can check the link in the description. I'll add the code in there so that you can download it and you can directly check whether it's working for you or not, right? So now let me upload it. So this is the line through which I'll be simply building it, and accordingly I'll be flashing it. So let me run it. And just because my ESP32 and my device is directly connected to my system, so that's the reason I don't have to connect it. So I'll simply run this command and it will simply upload the code for me. All right, everyone. So you can see the code is uploaded successfully, and also now our device is connected to the Wi-Fi as well as to the Firebase. So now, before deploying our device to the live, let's first test that whether we are getting the signals according to the data that we are going to send from the Firebase real-time database or not, so that we can do this controlling thing, right? So for that, let me go to the Firebase. So everyone, you can see this is a real-time database which we created in a previous video, and you can see this is the data that we just uploaded. Or you can say when our ESP32 connected to the Firebase, this is the initial data that it pushes to this Firebase account, and in fact this real-time database, and that's the reason you can see we have the initial values as 0. Now I want to show you, if I'll send the different value, what is going to happen. So I'll simply put 1 in here. You can see we have got this data, and here we have the values for all the four appliances. So with respect to this data, first appliances is turned on, and along with this you can see we have got the values as well, or you can say we have got the message printed for each of them. So the first condition was executed, which is let me show you here, this one. You can see relay one turned on. So the condition gets true, that's the reason this message has been printed over here, right? And the others are turned off just because we have the 0 value for them. So that's the reason else condition is executed. Now let me put another values, 1 for this, you can see 1 and 1, 1 for this, 1 and 1, turned on. Similarly the last one. In this way we have simply done it. You can send the 0 value as well, in either of the case it's gonna work, right? So this is the way like how we have done it, and I'm sure you have got the clarity like what exactly we are doing. So everything is working now with our device that is connected to our system right now. Now it's time to deploy it and to check in the real time. So let's do that.
So now currently you can see all the switches are off, but still this is the light which is turned on, right? So now I'm gonna show you how we can control it. So let's do that.
So now you can see, everyone, the light which I'm showing you on the screen, this is turned on. And same thing you can see on the Firebase account, right? Over here, the appliances number 4, which is given the value as 1. So currently the value is set to 1. That's the reason it is turned on. Let's say if I will change this to 0, you will notice that the light is turned off. So let me do one thing. Let me change the value again so that we have the lights in the room. So in this way, we have the light turned on. Similarly, you can see we have 3 more appliances which I have connected to the device. Now, let me show you one by one so that I can show you how exactly they are working, right? So let's check with the appliances number 3 and let's see which one is it. So you can see some new lights are added. Let me show you that either. So you can see this is that light which is turned on, and same thing I can do with this also. This is appliance number 3. Let me change the value to 0. You can see light is turned off. So let me turn it on again. Lights turned on, right? In this way we have it. Now let's see how to turn on the fan. And for that, let me change the camera angle to the fan side. So you can see the fan is on the screen and currently it's turned off. Now let me turn it on. See, the fan is turned on. Now in the similar way, I can change the value and I can turn it off back. Otherwise we will have this sound right here, right? So let me turn it off. I'll put the value as 0. So the fan is turned off, right? In this way we are doing it. So this is the way like how we can control the appliances with the Firebase account.
So this was it for today. I hope you guys have liked this video and you have liked this project too. So if you have liked this video, do click on the like button. And if you are new to this channel and if you haven't subscribed to our channel yet, do click on the subscribe button so that you will not miss any updates from our channel. And also you can comment below in the comment section if you have any queries related to anything, like related to device, related to components, or related to anything, right? So feel free to leave a comment below and I'll see you in the next video. So till then, bye bye and happy learning.